My tongue won't do that.
Hi, I'm Wine Dine Carolyn. I'm a wine expert chef, recovering archaeologist, and expat living in Lyon, France. Right now, I'm in one of my favorite wine producing countries on the planet, beautiful Croatia. Let me know you're watching by liking this video, subscribing to my channel, and typing Croatia in the comments. You may be thinking, and I've heard it before, what, Croatian wine? And the answer is yes. So without further ado, here are five things you need to know about the incredible wines of Croatia. First things first, a little history. Croatian wine is OG. It's a whole thing and it always has been. Just because you don't see it on the shelf at Trader Joe's doesn't mean it doesn't exist. Look at where Croatia is. It's right next to Italy on the Mediterranean. These folks have been making wine since the dawn of time. But for real, since at least as far back as the era of the ancient Greeks, 2,500 years ago, and most likely even earlier. Grapevines have been grown and wine has been made in this part of the world forever. During the Roman times, the wine from Croatia was famed for its quality, exported all over the empire, and it was generally a BFD. Fast forward to the late 1800s when a grape pandemic, a tiny bug called phylloxera, wiped out most of Europe's vineyards, including eventually those here in Croatia. This devastated vineyards and winemaking communities, and a lot of people left the country. Which leads me to the second thing you need to know about Croatian wine. Lots of winemakers emigrated in the 19th and 20th centuries and settled outside of Europe where they established their own vineyards in countries like Chile, New Zealand, and the USA. The most famous of these is Mike Gergich of Gergich Hills, one of California's greatest winemakers. The 20th century was not kind to this part of the world. We have World War I, World War II, communism, and civil war. For most of the 20th century, the focus was on big government-run wine cooperatives who focused on quantity over quality. The war for Croatian independence finally ended in 1995, and since then, Croatian winemakers have been working hard to restore their winemaking legacy and international reputation. Of course, there are vineyards of Sauvignon Blanc and Cabernet, but you're much more likely to see clusters of consonants that feel pretty unpronounceable to the average English speaker. Don't be scared, these Croatian grape varieties are awesome. Here's a short list of some of the grapes you might come across at a Croatian wine shop. Most famously, we have Plavac Mali, which is the child of Zinfandel, known here as Srilnjak, Srijelinek, Kaštelanski.
Okay, this seems like a good time to press pause and check in with my friend Mata about how to actually pronounce these grapes.
Zinfandel.
No, come on, what's the other name for it?
Zinfandel, we say Zinfandel also.
It's like Klernak.
Krljenak.
Okay.
Krljenak. Yeah, it's. There is a very difficult
Klernienak, Kaštelanski, right?
Kaštelanski Krljenac.
Okay.
Krljenac.
My tongue won't do that.
Yeah, you have to slap up from your mouth.
Klernienak.
Krljenac.
Klernienac.
Krljenac.
Klernienac.
Letter by letter.
Okay.
K.
K.
R.
Kr.
Kr. L. L.
Kr.
Kr.
L.
Krljenac.
Krljenac. Oh, I get it.
Ah, you're getting there. You're getting there.
Krljenac. Yeah.
Exactly.
Okay. And that is what is another name for Zinfandel.
Both Plavac and
Krljenac
are bold, juicy, tannic, and boozy. On the whites, we have some highly aromatic varieties like Graševina, which is otherwise known as Welsh Riesling, Malvasia, Estarka, Vugava from Island Viz.
The locals like to say Vugava.
Bugava.
It's Bugava, but they like to say Bugava.
Poship and Gurk. There are loads of other grapes here, and one day I hope to try them all. At the moment, the majority of the wine made here is white, although the reds are very compelling. Next, let's get to know the regions. Now, there are 300 geographical distinctions divided into four bigger regions. Two are inland, two are coastal. For the inland, we've got the coldest region of the Croatian uplands. This region features mostly very small family wineries making crisp whites, dessert wine, and some lovely sparklers. To the east, we have Slavonia and Danube. Fun fact, Slavonian oak is very high quality and used by plenty of winemakers throughout Europe, particularly in Italy. Here we have some much bigger wineries and vineyards, with the main focus being on Graševina. Today, the really exciting wines for me are coming from the coastal regions. The northern part of the coast is Istria and Kvarner. This includes the Istrian Peninsula and plenty of islands, including the delightfully named island of Krk, which makes another fabulous white from an indigenous grape, Zlatina. This region is very focused on quality, and although there are many successful vineyards planted from the French varieties, people really are focusing more and more on maintaining indigenous vineyards and promoting these native grapes. Finally, we have the Dalmatian coast, which is where I am right now. This is where the majority of the red comes from, most of it from the fabulous Plavitz Mali. It's in Dalmatia that we have the first EU-protected regions of Dingac and Pašta. And finally, the most important thing you need to know about Croatian wine is that it's really good, and it's still really good value, although prices are deservedly going up. So go now, find it, drink it, tell your friends about it. If you like learning about new, different wines and need a nudge to go out and taste them, head to the link in the description to join the Digital Tasting Club. It's my monthly membership where we meet up once a month to taste 4 different wines from all over the world. And I'll even send you 4 unique recipes to pair with them.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
And everyone, come visit Kapa Wine Bar in Komisha, because it's the best.